The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus went to the Mount of Olives. Early in the morning, he came again to the temple. All the people came to him, and he sat down and taught them. The scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery. And placing her in the midst, they said to him, Teacher, this woman has been caught in the act of adultery. Now, in the law of Moses commanded us to stone such. What do you say about her? This they said to test him, that they might have some charge to bring against him. Jesus bent down and wrote with his finger on the ground. And as they continued to ask him, he stood up and said to them, Let him who is without sin among you be the first to throw a stone at her. And once more he bent down and wrote with his finger on the ground. But when they heard it, they went away one by one, beginning with the eldest. And Jesus was left alone with the woman standing before him. Jesus looked up and said to her, Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you? She said, No one, Lord. And Jesus said, Neither do I condemn you. Go and do not sin again. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends in Christ Jesus, we have two interesting stories from the Gospel and from the first reading. I'm sure we all have heard it and read it lots of times. Looking into the first reading, we see Daniel standing up for Susanna. I was so much captivated by the prayer when Susanna was being plotted against. The two elders would come to Susanna and would say, Commit sin with us. And she said, I would rather fall into your wicked scheme than to sin against the Lord. I would rather have you destroy me than sin against the Lord. It brought to me the memory of Saint Maria Goretti. Lots of other people who have been martyred also for the sake of keeping their purity. My dear friends, ask ourselves, when the world is scheming against me, when the people around me turn against me, do I compromise myself? Do I give in myself that I would just go with a clean image in front of the world, but sin in the sight of the Lord? Let Susanna be an example for each one of us. She cried, I would rather fall into your hands and be condemned to death by the society than sin against the Lord. This should be an eye-opener for each one of us. The world is always plotting against me. Sin is always lurking around the corner. People would do anything to, put me and pull me into the sinfulness. But it is me, it is I who have to stand up and say, You would rather destroy me, but I will not sin against my Lord. That should be our attitude in the face of temptations, in the face of wickedness of those around us. Let us be strong. And sure, like Lord Saint Daniel, he would send someone in our lives to console us, like the angel was sent to Jesus in Gethsemane and in the desert. The presence of Lord will be always with us. And let us come to the Gospel of today. If Susanna was innocent, we see a sinful woman. She was caught in the act of sin. And in today's society, people will ask, where are the male counterparts? Why they only bought the woman? Because in the Jewish times, they thought it was a responsibility of the woman to keep the purity of the heritage. And the men was overlooked. Maybe it was the way the society functioned. Whatever may be, the woman was brought to Jesus. And they would either say, if Jesus was ready to forgive, he is doing against the law. If Jesus say, condemn her to death, he is contradicting himself of mercy and compassion. Now, this story of the adulterous woman is an eye-opener for us when we prepare ourselves for confession. Look into the last verse. Neither do I condemn you. Go and do not sin again. That's what the Lord wishes us to do. This is a rare occasion where we see the people are being honest. Jesus say, let the one among you without sin cast the first stone, and they left because the conscience of guilt was awoken. We see the first one who left was the eldest one. And we know as we move on in our lives, we accumulate our sinfulness. We sin more and more. And the eldest one was the first one to leave. And Jesus says, neither do I condemn you. When we stand before the Lord, seeking mercy and pardon, when we confess our sins, even though the whole world condemns us, my Lord will say, I will not condemn you. Go, I have forgiven you. But with one condition, do not sin again. In today's world, confession may be seen as a license to sin. It's like an escape path. Whenever I sin, I would say, it's okay. I'll just make confession on the next week and I will just walk without any problem. No. When we stand, go for confession. When we ask for mercy and pardon, the Lord wishes us, I will forgive you. I will be merciful towards you. But please, please, do not sin again. This should be our solution. So these two aspects of both incidents, even if the whole world will destroy me, I will not commit a sin against my Lord. The words of Susanna. And the words of Jesus, I have forgiven you. Go, but do not sin again. Let this propel us towards the passion and preparation for Easter. May the good Lord bless us all. Amen.